everybody. I'm back. This is Sharon. I'm going to do something a little bit different. Get rid of the bubbles here. I have a 10 by 10 canvas, and I have some ivory placed down on top of the canvas. I just did it, so get the bubbles out. A while ago, I did a bottle cap pour, and it turned out looking like an English vine with flowers on it. It was really pretty. I just finished varnishing it, or I would show it to you. But I did it right through here, and it had vines coming out with little flowers. I'm gonna do the same thing, only I'm not gonna use a bottle cap. I'm gonna use these little baby balloons, little water balloons, little teeny tiny water balloons. And I just did an experiment with the green, with this one that has a tip on it, and it makes like little clovers. You can see my dog down here. And then I have a paper towel here to wipe it off. Everything. So I'm going to try and create a painting that's somewhat realistic looking with water balloons. Why not, right? All right, so let me zoom you in a little bit. Okay, let me scooch up and let's do this. Okay, so I have over here some paints that I've put down. I have like a lime green, a sea mist green, some lavender, Prussian blue, light blue, regular green, pink, orange, magenta, and yellow. Okay? So I'm going to start out with doing the leaves first, and I'm going to take a little bit of paint and put on the end of my balloon, and I'm just gonna kinda dab it on my paper towel so it's not super concentrated. Yeah. I was just really afraid I was gonna put too much paint on there, so that's why I did it that way. But I think it's okay to have some paint on there. Yeah, I was just afraid it was gonna mess it up, so. And I'm gonna end up mixing all these colors up, so if that's the case. See, it looks like it makes little clovers. Should I move you in a little bit more, maybe? There. Okay. So, I'm gonna kind of mix these colors up a little bit and just get these vines put down here. And when it starts to get kind of yucky, I'll just wipe it off. How I thought of this. I just thought of it before I was gonna actually go to bed. I was varnishing that painting. It looks like an English garden. It's just very, very light and dainty with all these little leaves going up. And I thought, you know what? The way that it looks, it almost reminds me of a balloon smash. Is with little little cute little leaves and vines, and I thought, you know what, I bet I could do this with a little water balloon. And I just happened to buy some water balloons the other day because I saw them and they were like 59 cents for a whole package of them. And I went, oh my gosh, I could have so much fun with those. So. There's been some weird stuff going on around here. I keep hearing banging outside. And I don't know, now my dog's hearing things and she's got some pretty sensitive ears. So I just think, I don't know. The neighbors upstairs moved and they were pulling the carpet and putting in carpet, and you know how they hear this bam, bam, bam as they're putting the carpeting in? Well, I'm hearing that yesterday at 3 o'clock in the morning. I'm like, what the hell are they doing up there? And the people upstairs are generally kind of heavy-footed, kind of noisy in a way. But I heard it again, and it's 1 in the morning. There shouldn't be anybody up there slamming carpet, stretching carpet. I don't know if you've ever seen it before, that they bang their knee up against this block thing and it pulls the carpet and then they tack it down. And I'm like, what the heck? What is going on? And I'm ready to grab my pistol and bring it in here with me because something's just weird. I don't know. Okay, I don't want to do overkill here. So I think I'm going to leave the green the way it is there. And I'm going to make sure my door is locked. And I'm going to grab Walter, my 380, and bring it in here with me. Walter safely sitting next to me here, so I'm gonna grab that other painting and show it to you really quick. Let me get it. It's dry enough now. So this is what I did before. Kind of looks like a little English garden. Very dainty. And this was a bottle cap pour. And then I kind of with this flower right here, I took the pick part of a dental floss like this and just kind of played with it a little bit to give it some definition. And this is how it turned out. And I thought, you know what? I bet I could recreate that with the balloon. So that's why I'm doing it. Let me hang this back up where I had it to dry. Right back. Thing is, there's no cars out there. I'm gonna open my blinds. And if I see, and I'm gonna take Walter here, and I'm gonna have him displayed in full view. Just don't fall, Walter, and shoot anybody. Walter is my Walther PK380 pistol that I absolutely don't go anywhere without. Oh no, I don't normally get spooked, but this is just really weird. It's just very strange that there's noises going on. It's not the one directly above me, it's the one above the person next to me, but like the very corner of it is corner with me. So I can hear everything that goes on, and I'm like, 3 o'clock in the morning yesterday, I'm hearing this bam, bam, bam. And the guys that, there it goes again. And the guys that were, okay, I'm gonna start doing flowers while I'm talking here. And the guys that were up there today doing the carpeting, I asked him, I said, were you up here at 3 o'clock in the morning doing this? He's like, no, I was sleeping. I said, well, that's what I figured, but there was somebody up here who sounded like they were stretching carpet. He's like, well, that is really strange. And I'm like, yeah. So I called the landlord and I said, just so you know, there's some really weird stuff going on. So, I don't know. Now, some of these I'm just barely tapping. I think it's this technique right here is so much easier than the bottle cap pour, because you have way more control. I'm gonna put a little bit of yellow in the middle of some of these little flowers here. Oh my gosh, my other balloon popped and I have no idea how. It just burst. And it scared the crap out of me. I thought Walter tried to shoot me. Walter, you lost your big bang there, buddy. That scared the crap out of me. Why would my balloon pop? It wasn't sitting on anything. Oh my God, that scared me. That was funny. Did you hear that on the video? That was just too funny. Way too funny. Well, maybe not that much that funny, but okay, now we got a little bit of pink here. A little bit of magenta. Let's get a little magenta down here. Up here. Dark there. Okay. Wipe it off. Is everybody having fun? I'm having a wonderful time. God, I love this. This is just, it's so pretty and dainty. This is wonderful. Little bit of paint there because it's just a little much. I feel like I have a dog hair up my nose. It's driving me crazy. Wow. This is so cool. Okay, this right here has already got little tendrils coming down. I'm just gonna help them a little bit. This is really pretty. Oh gosh, I could do this every day. Let's get a little bit more of this blue in here. Thank you. overkill here, though, but I want it to be... Alright, somebody answer me a question. Why in the world did God create frickin' nose hairs? Why? They are the most annoying things on earth. I mean, why would you do that to somebody? I don't know, it's just somehow a way to torture people without exactly knowing that you're torturing them. Oh my gosh, this is so gorgeous. I am just absolutely loving this. To do another one. I can't believe that balloon popped. I don't even know where it went. It just like flew in the air and popped. There's nothing here to make it pop. That is just so bizarre. All right, so I have a paintbrush here. It's really, where the hell is the camera? It's really thin. So I think I'm going to take just the end of my paintbrush and get some little feathery things going here. Try and do that. Maybe some little doohickeys. Give it a little bit of depth here. This a little bit better too. Let's get some paint out of that. Such a good song. This is from Spider-Man, the very first one. Green and pull that up there. my phone. And there's my balloon. Where the heck is my phone? I'm wondering if the balloon popped the phone off my... So I'm just going through and giving these flowers a little bit of texture. I really don't like the way this one looks. It just has a funny look to it. It just looks raggedy. So I completely make it disappear. There we go. That's much better. Hardly see it, but I put little teeny tiny blue dots there on that flower to give it a center, and then I'm going to take a little bit of light blue and just kind of highlight the inside of this, give it a little depth here. Yellow flower could use a little depth too, so we'll throw a little orange in there and liven it up a little bit. That we have here that could use a little help. Oh no, they're looking pretty good though. Let's get a little yellow in the middle of that. This might sound gross, but the easiest way to get a really nice point on your brush is to just put it in your mouth and just pull it through your lips, and it will, of course I wiped it off with first, but, and it gives it a nice point, easier for you to use. All right, I don't want to overkill this, so I'm going to leave it the way it is. I can use a few little flowers down here. Just a little color. I don't want to go crazy, because we want this to look like it's kind of, you know, from a distance too. So I'll just pop a little color in there. Just a little bit. Give it a little contrast there. There we go. Alright, I think I'm gonna. Well, I got this one flower here that I really don't like. I forgot about that one. I'm gonna reboop it. Another boop. big and blobby. That way it gets some green in it and small it down a little. There we go. I like that better. Okay, so I'm gonna call this done because I don't want to overdo it. It is so pretty. And that's all done with a balloon. I don't know how well you can see that. Just a balloon, a little water balloon. Okie dokie, I'm gonna let this sit here and dry. Put way too much paint on my plate. Kind of makes me mad that I did. I know better next time just to put a few drops. It's kind of a waste. Now I feel like I should do another one just to get my paint used up. I just have a couple of streaks here from my brush from where I put the paint on. I just want to make sure that it does okay. Messy, messy, messy. Fix it. Must be pretty and dainty like the flowers. The paint, because it has Floetrol in it, it will level out. It won't stay blobby like this. It'll level out and look good. So I think that's gonna do it for this. I'm gonna call it a night. Thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. I had a blast with this. I think I might do this a little bit more. Maybe mix some different shades of green and purples, or just do all pansies one time and maybe try some roses or something. I'm pretty impressed with these little water balloons, these little boopers. I call them boopers because they're so little and you just kind of put the paint on there and go boop. Yeah, I know, I'm weird. But that's okay. All right, well, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it gave you some inspiration to try something different, please let me know. I really appreciate any comments that you have for me. If you don't like it, if you can think of a better way to do it, or some ideas to add to it, let me know. I appreciate any comments whatsoever, any advice. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. I could always use some new friends in here giving me tips and pointers. So that's gonna be it for tonight. Thank you very much again for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.